I'm Asterios Kokonos, and this is Misaka.
And I'm Sriracha, and this is Louise. Tonight on Waifu Wars, we've got a real live anime nerd here in the studio. He's never had sex with a real woman, but we have two anime girls he's interested in. You can only have one waifu for life, so tonight we're gonna make him choose on Waifu Wars.
We're really doing this. I wanted to do a show about this phenomenon I found out about where people are so in love with anime girls that it's not just like a crush, they're called their waifu. It means that like you're devoted to the anime girl for life. It's not, again, it's not just like, oh, I think Jessica Rabbit's hot. It's like you start a relationship with an anime character. Is that what a waifu is? Am I getting the definition right?
Right. See, you and I might look at Jessica Rabbit and say, hey, Jessica Rabbit's hot. Maybe I want to fuck her. But when you got a waifu, you want to fuck their personalities.
Okay. Please continue.
When you got your waifu, that's like your partner. You're together with your waifu for life-u. So now, one of the catches is, can't have more than one waifu.
Cause that does make sense because it's like a commitment you're making
right.
to a character. No, wait, that doesn't make sense. I don't know. You can't have a commitment to a cartoon character.
Well, you know, you see, 3D girls can get dirty, they can smell bad, they can cheat on you. But these 2D girls, these waifus, they're never gonna cheat on you. They're devoted to you forever. And in turn, you need to be devoted to them forever. As tastes change, as seasons change, your waifu is eternal. So today in the studio, we have someone here who just can't decide. He's between two waifus. And we're gonna figure out who he's gonna be bonded with for life-u.
I'd like to introduce our first guest. He's known for, well, being a living meme. His name is Chuck. He's the commander of Fort Waifu. We're gonna throw up a picture right now of the photo that made Chuck famous. Chuck, why don't you explain what the hell Fort Waifu is?
Sure. So I have a huge anime figure collection, which are these works of fine art you see here on the table. And they come in these large boxes. So I built a fort out of them in my dining room, floor to ceiling.
Wait, do you mean your mom's dining room or your dining room?
No, I have my very own dining room.
Okay.
Amazing. I'm breaking stereotypes left and right here.
How many girls are allowed in your house?
So I built the fort and I affixed a scrawled sign to the front of it that said, no girls allowed. And then the photo is me with these shades on and an assault rifle. sort of, you know, manning the fort and protecting it from girls, normies, casuals, interlopers.
Anybody that shouldn't be on your board.
Anyone
really?
Who might touch my waifu is the way that you guys keep
doing.
No, okay. It's okay. For now, I brought these ones. They're decommissioned effectively.
Well, it's great to have you here. Now, here's how the show Waifu Wars came to be. I do a thing where like I answer fan questions on a podcast. It's called the 5-Minute Podcast. I'm gonna plug my own work on my own show because I'm a huge shill. And Chuck was like, hey, I got these two waifus. I can't choose between them. I want you to help me understand which waifu I should go with, who should be my Japanese cartoon wife for the rest of my life. This is a big decision you gotta make. Now, I want you to walk us through this. Oh, wait, actually, we're gonna need a little alcohol first. Orion, can we please get the gin?
Here.
Thank you so much. This is Orion. He's nice enough to let us shoot this in his house and fill his house with panty ladies
this.
And boob ladies.
The FBI's outside.
Yes. The FBI shows up. We're not here, Orion. All right, so why don't you tell us a little bit about these anime girls you like?
Sure.
Do you want to touch the ladies, the pretty ladies?
All right. Louise Francois Leblanc de la Vallière, my primary first waifu, the first love from Familiar of Zero. Misaka Mikoto from a certain scientific railgun and a certain magical index.
Who's this? Is this one of them?
This is Louise. Yeah, this is Louise right
okay.
here. Who you see behind you.
Oh my goodness. All right.
So
I'm just real. I like that I'm holding this lady by her butt. These two figures are worth hundreds of dollars. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Explain to. Walk me through the value of these and why you're letting a drunk weirdo hold them on camera.
They would retail for maybe 120, 130. They're both out of print, so you could probably find them for 180, 200 maybe.
Should I be touching these?
If your hands are clean.
Not like that.
No, that's not what I mean.
Has
anything ever landed on these that I might not? Is there, I'm just asking like,
yeah, I would like to know if I need to get a blood test.
Yeah, is it okay?
I would never defile my waifus in that way. That's disgusting.
Okay.
Although there is a genre of video out there that you will find where exactly what you are talking about happens and is filmed and consumed, you know.
They give them AIDS?
What? Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm going to put this down. I'm going to take it on faith that these have never been...
Soil.
Let's soil. That's a great word. All right. So let's start with this. What's this lady's name one more time?
Misaka Mikoto.
Okay. What is it about Misaka Mikoto, besides the fact that her figure literally comes on its knees? What about this girl are you attracted to?
Well, I mean, even this pose is kind of showing her personality. She's
yes, that's what it's doing.
She's
showing her real person, so her subservient personality.
No, she's demure. She's embarrassed that she's missing her skirt, and if you
why is she missing her skirt?
Well,
is there a plot related reason for that?
You have my permission, but look under the shirt. Just for, I know you want to. I know you've been thinking about it.
You look under the shirts for Racha.
She's wearing shorts.
Oh, that's a twist.
It is a twist.
Not expect. I thought they were definitely going to be.
It's a big departure from what you would expect, normally with these kinds of figures. But this character, so she wears shorts underneath her skirt. So it's the kind of person that she is. She's modest. And so this figure is really fun.
So you like girls that are cute, but they don't know it. That
yes.
type of thing?
Girl yes. next door stuff.
Right.
Yes, well, okay, so Misaka. So she's, let me tell you about Misaka. She's a class 5 Esper.
Wait, this one?
No, we're talking about Misaka.
This is Misaka.
She's a class 5 Esper.
Class 5 Esper, that's the most powerful.
Well, obvious. I mean, just look at her. Of course, he's a class 5 Esper. Tell us something we don't know.
Well, if
Chuck.
You saw her in person, you would feel her power.
Oh, I'm feeling her power.
Her, yeah.
I think is the word power another word for her butt? Oh, don't point that thing at me. All right, just keep
it's a work of art. You need to appreciate that.
That's true.
I'm just, okay. Tell me more about the Esper.
All right,
yes.
Okay,
the
class
Espers.
5, so she's very powerful. There's only maybe 3 in all of Academy City with that kind of power level. But she's modest about it. And, you know, she spends her time trying to help people, trying to, beat up bad guys. And she ends up getting a crush on this guy who's really got no abilities of his own except for his right hand negates abilities. So he doesn't really, he's not very powerful. He can't really do anything. All he can do is stop things.
What's he doing with his left hand?
not.
You don't have to answer that, Chuck. All right, so this guy that she's into, this guy sounds kind of like an audience surrogate.
He's an everyman.
An everyman. Exactly. Okay. Tell us what okay. about the guy.
Yeah, so Toma, identify with him. He's just like kind of a lower class guy, regular guy. He's got no abilities. He's, and so he's kind of below her station. And that's why when she gets a crush on him, she's embarrassed about it. And she can't just sort of openly say it and be forthright with it. And so that romance between them, that awkwardness, and it is like a high school thing. So it's kind of brings back those memories of, that the awkward romance of high school and just with her, she's got this godlike power, but then she's got this crush on a guy who's kind of beneath her, and then, you know, they get into fights and she tries to electrocute him, but he can stop it because that's what he does, is he stops things, and so that frustrates her. She's a brat, she's spoiled, but at the same time she's got this soft side and she's got this crush that she's embarrassed about, and she's flat-chested and she's insecure about that. So she's got these vulnerabilities.
The worst thing you can be.
That's true.
I didn't know. I'm so sorry.
That's not
being
true.
Being flat-chested is like character trait in the animes?
Oh, yeah.
No, that's, there's a...
Oh, yeah.
Tell me more, wait. I just can't imagine a character in a cartoon being defined by their bust size.
Yeah.
Tell me.
They actually, anime series, they design their characters to appeal to a bunch of different body parts. You want big fat tits? Of course you do. You want a medium?
There are wars that are waged on which breast size is the best. You know, people line up in these factions. I happen to favor what's known as DFC.
Which
what
means
is that? No, I don't know what that means.
A delicious flat chest.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, that obviously, so let me just clarify that can apply to adult women. My girlfriend.
Yeah, no, I know plenty of girls with no boobs.
And that appeals. You know, there's an argument to be made for that, and there's character archetypes that are built around that and with insecurities about that called Petanko.
And Petanko.
Both of these
characters. What does Petanko mean in American?
I have no idea. What is it?
I don't know what it translates to, but it describes that character archetype who is flat-chested and insecure, specifically insecure about that.
You guys have a... There's an archetype that's about a lady who's worried that her boobs are
yes.
too small?
Yes.
It's big, recurring. Big archetype. Yeah, there's entire series about that.
It's very important.
I can't name one, but I'm sure there are.
No, I believe you both. I just wish I didn't have to. Okay.
Everyone thinks guys want these giant cow udders. It's not always true. It's not always true, not everywhere. You know, Asian women tend to have, you know, a smaller bust size that appeals to some people. And yeah, I think it's something that anime caters to, like Sriracha mentioned.
Sriracha, what's your ideal anime lady bust size?
Yeah, good question, good question.
I like maybe the size of grapefruits. Nothing huge, nothing too big, nothing that looks like somebody stuck a hose in and went.
But a lot of that.
No, yeah. none of that flat.
None of the extremes.
No.
She's a moderate. No. She's
exactly.
Moderate. I can respect
yeah.
that. That's fine.
I like a little bigger than average.
Okay.
I'm straight.
But when is just.
I am a heterosexual female. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I just happen not to be that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It gets past a certain point when it's just too much. It's too much. It's got too much going on. It right. doesn't look natural. Yeah. Disgusting. It comes up
like
in anime
if you're
all the
time. Running and they're going two
different
directions.
Yeah.
That happens.
Happens a lot.
That happens in real life.
High School of the Dead is famous for the scene where her boobs dodge the bullet, sort of independently from her body. I wasn't impressed with that. Although a lot of people seem to enjoy it. Not my cup of tea.
This is the funny part about what you just said. Our editor is definitely gonna put like a clip of that happening under you saying it.
It's famous. It's famous.
It's famous, huh?
Yeah.
So here's the bad news. Now I have to watch that scene because I'm gonna sit in on the edit of this.
Well, which side are you on?
I don't care. Like, I genuinely. I can't think of a single character where I'm just like, if only the boobs were a different boob size.
Really?
Yeah.
You've never seen a beautiful woman and thought, well, if only the chest situation was a little one way or the
one
other.
One way.
You've got to have a preference.
Yeah,
guys spend their whole lives thinking about this topic.
I've dated all kinds.
Okay.
It's no, please never, tell us.
No, look, I wouldn't lie about it.
Okay.
I had a, because it's like, look, I'm not going to be embarrassed by what I like. But I swear to God, it's never occurred to me that I was just like, too small, too big. It's like, look, if there's a lady showing me her boobs, God bless that lady. Like, I'm not gonna be like, pass, fail. Like, what the fuck position am I in?
Because you don't have anime women throwing themselves at you all day, every day, years on end. You
like he does.
Right, like I do. I have to make this hard decision and I have to decide where my priorities are so I can advocate for, you know, what I'm into. So I understand your perspective, but it's...
You can only have one waifu and you bond with that waifu for life. Yeah.
Okay.
You never get rid of that waifu.
So this lady, she's got a smaller bust.
Yes.
Can we just say bust? Can we not say tits? Can we?
Nobody
not?
Said tits.
Nobody
said.
I said tits once 20 minutes ago. Move on.
Okay.
Everybody's been saying boobs.
All right. Okay. Let's all just agree on the common nomenclature of boobs.
Boobs?
Boobs or bust?
I don't.
Or lack thereof.
This is so.
Chesticles? Chest. 21.
Oh, okay, moving on. So this lady's got the bust size that you prefer. She's in love with a unassuming.
With a normie.
With a normal guy who so you can kind of see yourself in that position. She's kind of bratty though.
Yes.
Does that?
Yeah.
Does that appeal to you?
For you?
So she's a tsundere, and they both are.
What's a tsundere?
A tsundere. So tsun means like, it means like nice. And dere means, not nice. And so it's a combination of those two.
That sounds like every girl I've ever dated. Please continue.
It's a combination of those two traits. So they have a harsh side at first. And then, if they have a crush and they like you and they're trying to just put up this front of being, like I said, harsh.
But they gotta warm up to you. Yeah. Like, not everybody's gonna dump their affection all over somebody.
You gotta work for it.
Sometimes you gotta make a guy lunch and then tell him that it's because he made too much.
Yeah.
It's not that I like you or anything.
Exactly. She knows.
Yeah. Wait.
That's right.
I wanna get that again. What about the lunch? You're saying this lunch thing like I'm supposed to know what you're talking about.
Everybody that watches anime is gonna get that joke.
Okay, it was a really funny joke. I'm not seeing the joke. Explain the joke. I'm normal. No, I don't watch.
That's okay. So he's into tsunderes. So something a tsundere will do is she wants the guy that she's interested in to like her, but she's too proud. So she's not just gonna come out and say, hey, I like you. That's made this for you. So she's gonna do stupid bullshittery. Like she's gonna say like, oh, here, I made this lunch, but not because I like you or anything. It's just because I went to the store and I bought too much food and then I cooked that too much food this morning and I put it in a box for you.
But not for you.
But not for you. No. I did it all by accident.
And if you even look at her like, oh, so you're doing something nice for me, she'd probably smack
She'll probably
the shit
hit
out
you.
Of
you. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then, you both said she'll hit you at the same time. Like, this is a thing I'm supposed to know.
Yes, tsundere, yeah.
Yep.
Classic.
So
they're pretty violent at times, abusive. Yeah.
Hilarious.
And you're in love with this girl?
I mean, she's holding a riding crop and a chain and collar for a reason.
Oh, yeah. Louise, are we ready to move on to.
Yeah, let's talk about the other one. Okay, Sriracha's holding, what's her name?
Louise, for short.
Okay, what's her full
name? What's her full
name? Louise Francoise LeBlanc de la Vallière.
Is she a noble or something?
She is, she's an aristocrat. She's magic nobility. In her world, all magic users are the nobility. If you can't use magic, you're a peasant, ruled over.
Okay.
And, but unfortunately for Louise,
the food's here. I'm not allowed to touch toys anymore. Other people touched. I am terrified of breaking one of these ladies' legs. I'm not even kidding.
Yeah, they're
not. What are you doing to the animes?
Yeah, now kiss.
They're never handled like this.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. You're gonna be the official toy toucher.
Toy toucher.
Can we give her a title that just says that right underneath her?
Can we put that on my resume too?
I feel better about a female touching them, anyways.
Okay,
really
uncomfortable. No, because I'm not touching them in a sexual way.
Yeah.
Not like somebody else.
You just made them kiss. You just made them
kiss.
That's
fine. That's fine. She's a female.
Maybe it was an accident. Maybe one of them is running to school with toast in her mouth. Oh, no, I tripped over a rock.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I no, like I didn't. Think. I didn't mean to do that. My mouth just happened to fall on your mouth.
The
thing that happened.
You can create an anime. I would watch it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's going to be my next business venture. Why are you looking at me?
Because you guys are talking.
What, you've never seen?
Same,
you've never seen a beautiful girl running to school late with a piece of uncooked toast in her mouth? Right, uh-huh. Because she's so late that she doesn't have time to hold the toast. She just got to stick it in her mouth, out the door.
Very
you're
cute.
Running, you trip. Oh, no. Maybe your boobs are going two different directions.
Yep.
And you fall on someone, maybe another beautiful lady. Mm. And your mouth falls into their mouth. What, that's never happened to you?
No, I live in the real world where, why is she running with toast in her? We're moving on. This lady, Francois LeBlanc Del Vierre, lady name.
That's not her name.
What's her goddamn name?
Her name is not
Louise.
Lady.
Just call her Louise.
Louise, okay, we're gonna call her Louise. Tell me about Louise. Okay, so she's magic nobility.
Yeah.
She's got a riding.
Yes.
I'm noticing she's got a riding crop, but I think that's compensating for something, maybe in the bust area.
True, very true.
So
actually,
she's got a small figure as well.
Yeah, so in one way she's the opposite of Misaka in that Louise gets the nickname in school, Louise the Zero, because despite being magic nobility and having being able to do magic, she has zero aptitude for it. So anytime she attempts to do magic, it pretty much, it literally blows up in her face. And so she's relentlessly bullied at school and called Louise the Zero. And then I guess in your second year of magic school, you have a summoning ceremony where you summon your familiar. And this is like a little Pokemon or a Pokemon, sometimes they're big, and they follow you around for life. It's your pet. And everyone's joking about that she's gonna fuck it up and not be able to summon anything. And she ends up summoning a human. And actually, like, just a regular guy from Japan pops out of this summoning portal.
Was that an accident, or did she create a slave, or what?
She treats him like a servant. And a pet. And she's totally embarrassed, and everyone's laughing at her, like, you summoned a person.
Like, way to go, jackass.
Everyone else has like fire-breathing chameleons and dragons they can ride on that shoot things out of their mouths, and she's just got this like teenage guy.
Dude, yeah.
He's like, he doesn't even speak their language. So, I identify with that guy just because he's like a regular guy, you know.
Oh wait, that's also her love interest?
You can touch any part of your master's body.
Well, that's the thing, is like, not only is he beneath her, not only is he a peasant who can't use magic, but he's her pet and servant. And so that's why, like, she has a riding crop and a chain and a collar, because she treats him literally like a pet. He has to sleep on hay on the floor and wash her pantsu and, just wait on her hand and
pantsu.
Panties.
Yeah.
Really?
That's what we call pokey in Japan.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So
continue. No more questions.
So...
What are they called? Bras.
Burazu.
Do they really call them Burazu?
No idea.
I don't know. I'm asking you guys.
Do they wear bras? I don't know if they wear bras.
Yeah, nobody's got boobs. Why do they need bras?
This is all
so,
weird.
So, all right. Uh-huh. So she's got this pet servant familiar guy who she hates because he embarrassed her. But she slowly gets a crush on him, and he ends up kind of saving her and proving himself to be her equal, and in some ways her better, like morally. He kind of shows he does the right thing.
So he's not a total jackass.
No, and in both shows, the guy isn't a total piece of shit. There's a lot of anime shows where the guy is worthless, and he has like some goddess throwing herself at him, and I'm not into that. In both of these shows, the guy is definitely someone below their station, but is got some good qualities to him.
Okay. Well, it's... Oh, no, we're going to say...
Oh, so here's... Oh, so let me summarize your type and tell me if I'm correct or not. You like girls with flat chests,
yes.
Slimmer body types, that with powers that if yes. They were real 3D girls would treat you like shit.
Wait a minute, you're right.
And would, like, step on you during sex and weird stuff like that.
Yeah, you like these girls who were empowered.
You like dominant women.
Yeah.
I never put it that way. But
I think
yeah.
We're onto something.
You're onto something. Yeah.
You're onto something smart.
This is kind of the dominating, you know, being the powerful one. But then at the same, in both situations, think about it. With Toma, he can stop her. He's the only one who can stop her. With his right hand.
Right hand.
Yeah.
What were you thinking?
It's just weird to me that this guy's like got an anti-magic hand, and he's super into this girl who's completely magic. It's like, it's a little too neat. Like, I kind of like this one better because, like, she just summons a completely normal dude. So there's no, like, kind of, like, scripted reason that they're oil and water, except the fact that he's human and she's magical. You know what I'm saying? It's a little less contrived.
See, I don't agree. I think, Mikoto?
Misaka.
Would be the ideal waifu here because Misaka is...
That's Louise.
Okay. That's Louise. Do you not know that these two are the same person?
Pink hair. Just go with the hair. Louise.
They all look...
Yeah, but does this look similar to that?
I don't know, but they change clothes and stuff. So
no, they don't.
No, not really.
This girl plays a game on her phone where she can draw... Where she gets cards of cute girls, and then if she does really well... the car changed his outfit.
Love Live School Idol Festival, please add me.
What's your username on?
Oh, jeez, I don't know.
God damn it. We'll put it up on the screen. Yeah. Add her, give her Love Live points.
Yeah, give me, I don't think you could send points, but add me as a friend. No, the reason that I think she's because she's a hard worker, isn't she?
Yeah.
She's one of the most powerful espers, and she got there through her own thing. This little biatch over here, not only was she endowed with powers, naturally, but she doesn't even try. She can't do anything. And she's got this attitude about her that I think would wear thin very quickly. IRL.
Wait, which one? This one?
This one. This one.
Well, you said that this one's a brat, too. Which one's brat?
No, this one's a brat, but this is she's got the skills to pay the bills.
Okay. Like,
she can back it up.
She's a class 5 esper.
Right. This one, she's got powers, but you said she can't do anything. They
she's
call
Louise
her.
She's zero.
Because she's got zero.
She's just got a rich family.
Yeah. So she's just got a rich family, and she's mean for no reason. So at least this one, you're into brats, but at least this one is like, yo, yeah, I've got powers. And I'm all hottie because I can kick your ass. I think that's what it's called, right? Formally kicking your ass.
Haughty. Yeah.
Yeah.
But this one is gonna do all sorts of sex stuff to you.
Why? Because she's dressed mysterious.
Yeah.
It's not
no,
very
that's a good
liberal.
Point.
She's got a friggin'. She's gonna put this thing around your neck. She's gonna hit you with this thing.
So you don't think we could dress her up in something like that?
No. She's so modest. She wears shorts under her dress.
Yeah, didn't you hear about the shorts?
That's true.
That's the 900th time he's mentioned what she's wearing under her goddamn dress. She's, look, I think this one's better. I think this one's gonna try harder in bed because she's such a zero when it comes to magic stuff.
I better make up for it sexually.
That's what I'm saying. She's gonna take all her aggressions and frustrations out on you, on him.
That's a good point.
I think the sex is crazier with this one. I think with this one, you could eventually get there, but you'd have to have all sorts of conversations about what you like and what she like. There'd have to be all this communication and hand-holding. You might have to get, like, sex dice or something.
The worst thing that can happen in a relationship. Communication.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you. You're supposed to just, Anyway, with this one, it's just like, it's on.
Yeah.
It's on like Donkey Kong.
I really think you're just saying that because of what she's wearing. Look at that. Here, use this one for reference.
Not the 3D model I'm holding? Okay. Oh, what the hell? I didn't even look at this goddamn...
It's just...
I didn't buy any of this stuff, by the way. He brought
this
it all.
This isn't mine either.
This
I don't own this.
Probably in my home.
Okay.
Look, it's just... The wind is blowing. It's a pose. I mean,
it's a beautiful day.
She's holding a dick. This is the most phallic thing. She's holding like a fancy dick over here.
I've never seen Harry Potter, but I believe that it's called day.
Okay, a wandu or whatever the hell. She's a Satanist. She's got a fucking pentagram down
here.
Yeah,
Satanist, that's it. She's out of the running.
She's a witch.
She's a witch?
She's a witch, yeah.
But she's a shitty witch.
Yeah, she's not even a good witch.
Like Glenda.
Okay.
She's a bad witch.
I mean,
bad at witch. Which one of these girls from a purely sexual perspective, turns you on more. Hold them both up, please. No, hold them up for the camera.
Oh.
You're on the TV here.
Okay. Here's a question. Who would win in a fight?
That's a great question. Who would win in a fight?
Obviously Misaka.
Yeah, because she's terrible. So that's going back to my original. Terrible. So you tell us who turns you on more. I can tell that you are a guy
that likes
power.
This is like the water divining. Like,
yes. Like, who does the dog go to?
What does the boner point to?
Exactly.
Right.
I can't choose.
That's why you're on this show today.
That's you're supposed to help me out here because they're different.
It's
you know?
This one that turns you on more. She's got a goddamn riding
crop.
Well, yeah. Look at her for Christ's sake. But she's wearing a bustier.
There's something to be said for modesty.
Think about their personalities. Because you.
They've got the same personality.
They don't.
Tell me the difference between them.
No, I already told. She is haughty because she's confident in herself. This one. The only
she's insecure. Oh, that's a nightmare. You're gonna have to spend your whole time be like, no, you're good at magic. No, your magic's great. Oh my, I love your magic. Oh, you're really good at magic. And her name is fucking Louise the Zero.
She's terrible at magic, and she's a nobility. So if you would,
for the record, years later we discover she's a void mage. So there is something there, and it's a negation power. But, you know, she goes through school not knowing that. Nobody knows
more.
That.
Tell us more.
Yeah, so she's an incredibly rare mage, and that they weren't even prepared in school for a mage like this. They only come about every, you know, however many decades.
So they didn't write it, even bother writing it into the curriculum.
The syllabus has nothing to do with board mages.
Yeah, nobody knew. Yeah, no, there hadn't been one in so long.
Oh, wait, I think we got a chapter on this in the back.
She's able to do magic, but the spells everyone else are casting aren't the type of magic that she can do. And so near the end, you know, she learns about and taps into that power. And that's part of why she needs someone to support her during that time. Nobody else believes in her. She needs someone to believe in her and support her while she learns about herself.
But listen, do you want a project or do you want a partner? That's the question.
I mean, it seems like that's kind of the healthier relationship. That's the less of a codependent kind of thing. I mean, now that you phrase it like that.
Mm-hmm. I'm definitely leaning towards everything you're saying. Before we decide, though, I want to know a little bit more about where these characters both end up at the end of their respective series.
Right, spoil it for us.
Because here's the thing. If this girl sucks at magic, then by the rules of storytelling, at the end of the series, she has to save the fucking galaxy.
Correct.
Does she do that?
Yes.
So she's like the galactic savior, Louise.
Yep.
Who's also got like this hot riding crop to like hit you on the butt.
Yes.
Okay.
She's in tight with the queen. She's moving up in the nobility ranks. She's saves the world.
Okay. This one, she starts out as a class 5 Esper. Pretty fucking good.
Isn't it class 6? Which
one? Yeah, what does she end in? Class 7?
Five.
What class does she end in?
They have to
in?
Make
class
a whole five. New class.
No, she's a class 5 Esper at the top.
You're right.
But what does she advance to? Class 8?
There's not a lot of progression, honestly.
Interesting. Okay. What's the last thing that happens to her in her respective series? What's her last plot point or plot arc?
God, I don't really recall. It's episodic. So.
If you can't recall, maybe she might not be your waifu. Because you knew everything about this lady. You don't even know how this lady's show ends.
Is she the main character?
She is in Scientific Railgun, but not in...
So not in the main series.
In Magical Index, she's a side character.
Okay, so she's a side character. That's the only reason he doesn't remember. He remembers that because the show was literally named after her.
Oh,
that's why.
This is the main character in her show. Mm-hmm. Oh.
But she has her own show, too. So that's Scientific Railgun.
She even got a spinoff. That's how good at magic she is.
That's true.
What's Scientific Railgun?
So she has the ability to manipulate electromagnetic fields, and her signature move is taking an arcade coin.
I love the electromagnetic fields. 69 Love Songs, great album. I'm sorry, you were saying?
She takes an arcade coin and propels it at, you know, however many times to the speed of sound, and it wrecks everything. So
she murders people with an arcade token?
She's brutal.
You've switched over
okay,
to team.
Okay, I'm putting her down on this weird pillow she has. All right, so this lady can murder people with Chuck E. Cheese tokens.
She's dangerous.
Dave and Buster's.
Dave and Buster's?
Don't take her to a Dave and Buster's. Where would you take...
Well, Dave and Buster's uses a swipe card system.
Oh, that's right. I'm old school. Okay, so here's a question. If you were going on a date with each of these girls, where would you take them?
Good question. You're really good at this. At the show that I thought of. You should just be hosting this show.
I know nothing about any of this bullshit.
You seem to know a lot. You're very confident.
Don't
just
say
like
that
this
I'm
lady.
Looking for a job.
Okay.
Look, Louise is high class, nobility.
She's not going to be easily impressed.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, we can get into a lot of places that you couldn't normally get into. You know, with Louise at your side, she's got a lot of power, and she's got very refined tastes, so...
So you would go to, like, what, a fancy restaurant?
A magical castle, moat.
Oh, we're not in the realm of reality? No, I mean, like, in real life.
In real life?
If she was real,
yeah. She was in New York City?
Yes.
Take her to Tavern on the Green, take her some fancy place, the Russian Tea Room.
You gotta take her, you gotta take her to...
Applebee's.
Somewhere. Yeah, not Applebee's.
No. You know what? I could take Misaka, to Applebee's.
Do you think Misaka would like Applebee's?
Now I have a really good feeling about this one because if she's cool with Applebee's, then she's cool with me.
But don't I want to be nobility? Don't I move up in the world? Do I always want to be?
I'm asking you a serious question right now, Chuck. Because you don't seem like a social climber to me.
I could be a knight.
But could you deal with the paparazzi? Because a knight dating the princess, that's going to cause a little bit of scandal.
Yeah, like the ABC show.
A lot of jealous
scandal.
Guys.
Jealous dudes? You're going to have to kill them.
Answer to this bad boy.
You're going to have to this Pakistani. Lovely steel of Pakistan.
Pakistan steel.
How many swords do you own?
This is my only sword. It's the only one I need.
Why don't I believe you?
I don't believe you either.
I'm gonna put this down, okay? We're gonna say you own 8 swords.
How many of them are from Pakistan? Of the 8 that you own?
All right. Okay. If this one's cool with like a fun date at Dave and Buster's.
Yeah.
She seems very competitive.
She's a regular schoolgirl,
other
than being an electromagnetic wizard.
See, I think she would be, because she seems very competitive.
She is.
So I imagine that she would really like Dave and Buster's.
That's true.
Yeah, you could play the basketball thing, or you could do the trivia game, or you could play against each other in pinball and shit.
Yeah.
That's a fun date.
That's a fun date. This one, you're going to have to impress.
Yeah, you're going to have to put so much work into dating this one. Every date's going to have to be bigger and better than the next one.
And there's only so many high-quality restaurants in New York City.
That's right. Absolutely true. There's like 2 of them. Dave and Buster's.
And Applebee's.
And Applebee's, that's it. Here's the final thing, all right?
Okay.
Tell us.
Look, partway through the series, Louise, Saito's been working hard and has saved
Saito
her
life. Saito is her slave, right?
Her familiar, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
And so she decides she treats him so bad, she treats him like an animal, and she's like, I've been really too hard on him, and I want to do something nice for him. And his talking sword that's in the room convinces her that for a night, she should be his familiar, and he can be the master. She dresses up in this sexy cat outfit, and when he comes home, he actually has a bunch of friends with him, and she's super embarrassed, and then it doesn't go well. But the point is, she tries so hard, and she's willing to kind of put aside her pride to serve him and to be, you're my master for tonight. And I feel like Misaka would never do that.
You don't think so?
No.
Misaka would never lower herself.
She's...
I mean, except, of course, when she lowers herself onto her knees.
Literally, when she lowers herself.
Right.
Well, that's, you walked in on her, and she was... retrieving something, so she was surprised, that's why.
Okay,
so,
wait.
She doesn't want you to see her shorts.
So our familiars, you said normal people are like summoning dragons and fire-breathing cats and shit.
Right.
So why does she dress up as a prostitute when she wants to be his familiar? Is this like a code for sex or what?
Well, in that particular episode, they were in disguise at a tavern where the waitstaff all dressed like that.
Very convenient.
And so she was just blending in that particular outfit.
Oh no,
had to. It was for the job.
Oh, didn't you say though she came home?
No, the cat outfit.
Yeah, the cat outfit.
Yeah. So what about that?
Is that not a sex thing?
It was definitely like a sex thing. A sex thing.
Yeah, but why? No, but I'm saying people fucking their dragons, like fire-breathing cats. Why is she saying, "Oh, I'm gonna be a familiar.
No,
better dress as a prostitute."
Well, just like you're in control tonight. Like you can, treat me like,
a fire-breathing dragon and fuck me.
You're taking this in a very
making a lot of sense.
Oh, heavens, if we were to read too much into this riding crop lady who's got a fucking spike collar dangling around her delicate ankles. Jesus Christ. All right, Chuck, get out of here. We're going to make our deliberations.
All right.
All right. All right, well, Chuck's out of the room, and we're going to deliberate, and we're going to figure out, this is an important decision, who should be Chuck's waifu.
You can only have one waifu. So I know it's natural to sometimes when you've got a waifu for a long time to start looking at other waifus. But the truth is, if you want a lasting relationship with that one waifu, you can't have side bitches.
I completely agree. Like, the word waifu
is for laifu.
You say that? Is that a common phrase or did you invent that phrase?
I don't remember. I think I might have read it on 4chan somewhere.
You know that sounds like weird nonsense, right?
Oh yeah, like this has been a totally rational conversation all day.
Okay, all right. I honestly, I'm having a lot of trouble deciding between these two girls. I feel like you have a very strong opinion and I wanna hear it.
Okay, so here's what I think.
Okay.
On one hand, you have Louise, and Louise can do a lot of things for you that don't come from Louise. Like, she's nobility. If you get married to her, you're gonna be some kind of power. So the question is Charles really ready for that responsibility?
I don't think so.
When
did you see his tattoos?
Not ready for commitment.
I don't know, the guy's walking around wearing sunglasses?
It's just, I'm
saying. He's wearing sunglasses indoors. I don't think he's ready to be the king of Magic Town.
Is he the king? Is she like the princess? Okay,
whatever. No, you know this stuff.
Listen, Louise, I'm sure she's very good looking.
You sure?
In real life.
You what? Are you that afraid of being perceived as gay that you won't acknowledge that she's an attractive lady?
I just described my ideal boob size for a solid 7 minutes. Half an hour. Do you really think that's my concern here?
You know what?
Withdrawn.
Listen, Louise, she's nobility. She can get you places. Do you want to get into a table at a fancy restaurant? She's going to get that for you. But I don't think that her as a person would be a good waifu. Because like we said, your wife is for waifu. And if you can't commit to that personality, then you're going to have problems. It's not all about fancy parties. Not to mention that if you're dating the queen of magic, you gotta be on your A game all the time. Like, you gotta be like a Disney Channel star.
I'm thinking
you
the same thing.
You gotta be squeaky thing. Clean.
It sounds like so much work to date this pink-haired lady.
Yeah.
I'm having so... She's on her knees. This character was made on her knees. And she was made with, like, her butt going up the skirt. This is weird.
Goodbye, YouTube ad rev.
They sculpted this character with a wedgie.
Yeah, you know, an adult man sat down and said, this is what I want the figure to look like. This. Plot development. I want to include that. Now, see, the reason that I think she would be, honestly, both of these girls are going to treat you like shit. Like, imagine.
But he wants to be treated like shit.
He wants to be stepped under in sex.
Yes.
And I'm thinking that Misaka?
I don't know.
Misaka. Mikoto.
What's the name of the girl on her knees?
Yeah, Misaka Mikoto.
Misaka Mikoto.
Oh, I was right twice. Misaka Mikoto is going to be a girl that she'll warm up to you, but you gotta earn that. You gotta earn that, and for good reason. She's a class 5 Esper. She's very strong. She's very good at magic. She's got the skills to pay the bills. Louise? What does Louise have? Louise was born a rich person. The end. You're dating like the Paris Hilton of magic.
Chuck it in here. Okay, Charles, we've made our decision. Charles, you're going with whatever this one's name is.
Misaka Mikoto.
You're going with Misaka Mikoto.
This is your waifu.
This is your waifu. She's a lot easier to deal with. This one's a handful. This one is literally nothing but trouble.
And frankly, Charles, we don't think you can handle fame.
Yeah,
because I have tattoos and wear sunglasses indoors?
You heard that? We thought you were in a soundproof booth.
Tattoos are cool. I could be like a Yakuza guy in Japan. I probably am, you don't know.
Yeah, you'd have two less pinkies if you were a Yakuza guy in Japan. Holy moly. All right, this one's trouble. This one is gonna... You're gonna die of a drug overdose if you date this one right away.
You're gonna be dead at 40.
She's gonna be partying and you won't be able to handle it. You're a nice guy, Chuck.
And you need a nice waifu.
You need a nice waifu.
This is your waifu.
This one, she's dead to you.
Dead to you.
This one, literal trash.
I never wanna see this on your wall again.
Yeah, in fact, what we're gonna do is wait.
We have to get rid of it.
Before we tell you what we're gonna do, what do you think of our decision?
I respect the decision of the court.
Are you ready to give up this second waifu?
Yeah.
You haven't been through what we've been through together. So I don't know if you really understand, Louise.
Well, defend her then.
Yeah, defend our yeah.
Defend her.
Give me one good point that she has.
Tell us
that Misaka Mikoto does not.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess she has flaws.
Wait a second. I thought Misaka Mikoto's whole personality was her flaw.
No, I mean, I think she's got everything all together. I don't know. Part of me is attracted to Louise because she is insecure, because she has a life of expectations. She's trying so hard to act noble, and it doesn't really come naturally to her, especially when she doesn't have the powers that she's supposed to have. And so yeah, just that struggle and insecurity and just dealing with the disappointment of her familiar and all that, it really makes her seem like a deeper character. Misaka is a high school girl, and I mean, her fights, it seems a little superficial, and I feel like there's a lot more depth to Louise. Louise has suffered. Louise has lived a life of regretting not having the power she was supposed to have and not having friends. And so, you know, honestly, I was picked on a lot too. So I've always identified with the experiences Louise went through. Like, we would bond over that. We would have an understanding of each other that was deeper than you have a nice ass sculpture.
A very nice ass. All right, Charles, cover yours for a second.
All right.
What the fuck do we do? He seems to have really bonded with this one. And I think this girl's trouble, but I kind of like the idea that she's more human. Even though she's fucking magic.
Even though she's magic.
She's magic.
She's literally not human.
Wait, what?
She's literally not a human, but she is.
That's what I'm saying. There's something. He's making good points.
Making a lot of sense here.
Whereas this girl, she seems implacable. This girl won't ever change.
No, that's right. And maybe she can overcome her tsundere ways one day to finally express love. Because, you know, only one of them has development here. It sure isn't that one.
Yeah, especially in her chest. All right, but this one... Hey, cover your ears! But this one... Close your eyes, too!
I just don't know if...
Cover your ears with one... I want you to take one arm and cover your eyes so that you're covering one ear, and then cover your other ear. I want you to do this.
Get out of here, Drew.
No, stay right there. We can't have him just keep taking out and putting on his mic. We're gonna break everything.
Okay.
All right. He's making good points.
He really is.
Now you see what I've been going through. How hard this is.
Well, okay, why don't you tell us your attachment to Misaka Mikoto, then?
This one?
Yeah, that's it.
What if we take this and put this on this
girl? Yeah, does that turn
you on? Best of both worlds? I like the way you think.
It's only one waifu, okay? Get your head out of the gutter. Is your waifu for laifu? I've said that my whole life. I've always said that
my whole life.
Look, the arrangement we have, Louise came before. She's the primary waifu. Misaka is a secondary waifu.
So what drew you to
So if something that? Happens to Louise, God forbid.
So it's like a godparent situation.
Her, then Misaka is there as a secondary waifu.
Can she die?
Can she die?
Yeah, she's
I don't know how these magic
she's just
works.
A witch, that's all. She can die, sure.
I wouldn't be comfortable if I were your waifu.
To know you got a backup
yeah.
waifu.
Yeah, that's rough.
Yeah, what the
shit.
Hell? That's like a replacement goldfish. What are you doing?
Yeah, exactly. Oh yeah, Louise went to live on a farm.
She doesn't have to know. Don't tell her.
You're gonna keep a secret from your waifu?
You can't. See, I don't think you should have any waifu.
That's a really good. Are you ready for commitment?
I don't think you're ready.
Do any of those tattoos say commitment? I don't think so.
I think all of those tattoos say commitment.
All right, lifetime. Yeah, lifetime. Yeah, it's true.
Wait a minute. Should you have a waifu at all?
Maybe you're just into casual dating.
Yeah, maybe you should just...
date around a little?
Yeah, this is an important decision.
It's a big one. I need to Charles. I'm looking at these two waifus, and I'm thinking that they deserve a partner. They deserve somebody that can commit to them. I just don't know if you're ready to make that commitment.
That's true.
You can't have your cake and eat it too, Charles.
That's true.
So if you want...
You do deserve...
Magic queen bitch, or do you want real gun butt girl? It has to be a decision. And in the end...
I think I should... I think I'm ready to commit to Louise.
You're ready to commit?
Yeah.
I don't know that Louise is going to like the idea that you've got this railgun girl in your back pocket at all. And I think if Louise finds out, she's going to
be
fucking pissed at you. And I think that that kind of thinking is honestly immature. And it shows that you may not be ready for commitment.
She would be pissed. But then we would make up. It'd be really hot.
So are you ready to commit to Louise as your waifu? Are you ready to throw Misaka Mikoto in the trash?
Can't we be friends?
No.
No.
You made your decision. I think we all know what has to happen to this girl.
I'm sorry, Misaka. But Louise is the one I choose now.
Charles? you did the right thing.
And then Louise would understand and appreciate.
Do you have anything you want to say to Louise? Say it to Louise.
She's dead to you.
Misaka was just a friend, and I think I've shown that I'm serious and I'm ready to commit and be your husbando.
How can you make it up to her that you were carrying another girl around your... What can you do special for her to make up the fact that you were carrying another girl around in your pocket?
You know, besides decapitating this girl. What else can you do to make it up to Louise?
Let's be realistic.
I don't think it can get any more gruesome than what I've done to Misaka, so she's...
Okay, because one of our producers keeps saying that you should put this in a pan and light it on fire.
I don't know if that's necessary.